So this is the second part of the match photo tutorial, and on this part we are going to add in a few photographs, calibrate them, and do the basic masking of the building, and then we'll probably save the more detailed work for a third tutorial. So we're going to go add our photograph. Again, this is an uncropped photograph. I'm looking at the corner of the building. The first step I need to do is to use these guides to set my perspective grid. I'm not going to use the bottom of the building because I can't really trust that the bottom of the building is level. I want to be careful that if I'm using the bottom here, that I'm using the bottom here just to keep the perspective as accurate as it can be. Alrighty. So the one thing I haven't done yet is the scale. Sliding this will set the scale. These are 5 foot grids, and so if I know that my building is 25 feet tall, then I would have 5 grid lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But generally your building's going to be some odd number, or you won't be able to figure it out from this. So a nice way to scale it is to leave your calibration process and draw a line. I know the whole building height is 25 feet. If I didn't know that, but I knew the window was 6 feet, then I would draw a line by the window. But after you draw your line, use the tape measure tool and measure it. It tells me down here in the bottom right, 17 feet, 10 and 3 quarters. Before I do anything else, what you can do is change it and say, no, it's 25 feet, and type in 25 feet. SketchUp will ask you if you want to resize the entire model, and you click yes. Now if I measure that, it's now 25 feet. You could do this later in the process, but just to make sure we don't mess up the scale of anything else that's drawn, it's nice to just get that out of the way early on your first photograph. We make an EnergyPlus zone, I enter inside of it, and we start drawing. Things will look a little different here than what you're used to doing, because typically you'll draw in plan and extrude your height up. Here we're doing it a little differently. We're drawing in elevation, and then we'll extrude our building over. And I'm going to use a guide here. I don't have to do this, but just to make sure I'm pulling down my roof by the same amount, I'm going to draw a guide here. I'm going to delete my guides. Those were just something to help me keep my model consistent, which I could have fixed later, but now when I navigate up out of the camera view, you can see a few things. One, now I can shape my roof how it really is. I can delete the extra line, but I can also see my EnergyPlus colors that I'm used to seeing, which as soon as you jump back into one of your photo match scenes, disappear. So eventually we are going to model the fenestration, and we're going to model the awnings, but what I like to do when I'm going to do multiple photos is make sure they're calibrated well before we get too far. So a quick thing to do here is know what your next photograph looks like in relative to your first one. So the corner I modeled is over here. I'm going to use this corner for my next calibration process. You basically need to take your origin, which is now here, and move it to a corner that is visible on the other photo. Technically, this corner is visible, but it's a little too far away, so I want to pick something closer. So I picked this corner or that corner are good corners to start with. I'm going to navigate around to something close to that photograph so that when I import the photograph in, you can see my model relative to the photograph. This corner needs to go over here. So I'm going to just take it and move it over. I'm going to kind of navigate around here. I'm using my scroll wheel to kind of zoom in and out and move around. So I'm going to set that corner where it goes. I'm going to use the same calibration tools I used before to get my perspective right. Again, we're not going to use the ground. And we can zoom in and kind of check how accurate we are for this demonstration. I'm not too concerned. And we're also, just for the energy model, precision isn't as important as if you were doing this as an architectural model. So we've got our perspective set, but now I can use the scale tool to, and I think my origin's off just a tiny bit. Let's get on that corner and scale this down just right. Okay, so now we're good. So our scale is set. We don't need to rescale again. I'm going to draw this edge here, extrude my building back. This corner should line up with that corner. Everything looks just about perfect. And now our building's starting to look like a building. Now, if we were doing this for an architectural model here, right now this is an EnergyPlus zone, and I'm going to copy this zone for a minute, and then I'm going to explode this so it's no longer, now it's just SketchUp entities. It happened to be colored like EnergyPlus, but it really isn't. So if I were to project, this is something you would do if you were just doing this to model your building for what it looks like and not as an energy model. I can now navigate around and have, and I only did it from the first photograph, but you could do that all the way around your building and have all your fenestration. But in our case, we don't want to do that. So I'm going to delete all this. I'm going to paste my zone back in as a zone. And we will pick this up on the next tutorial.